أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الذين كفروا لن تغني عنهم أموالهم ولا أولادهم من الله شيئا وأولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، قال الله عز وجل: إن الذين كفروا لن تغني عنهم أموالهم ولا أولادهم من الله شيئا، أي لا تدفع أموالهم بالفدية ولا أولادهم بالنصرة شيئا من عذاب الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, definitely or surely, those who disbelieve, their wealth and their children cannot avail them anything from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their wealth, because normally in this world, if somebody commit a crime, if he's rich, he can ransom himself, he can pay a fine so that he'll be free. Or if he have children, very strong children, they can come to his assistance, they can come and help him to get out of the case. But in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the hereafter, your wealth and your children cannot avail you anything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ulaika, those who do the kufr, don't forget Allah is saying, talking about the kufar. Ulaika, those people, ashabun nar, they are the people of the hell, whom fiha khalidun, and they will remain in the hell forever. Now.
أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. مثل ما ينفقون في هذه الحياة الدنيا كمثل ريح فيها صر أصابت حرث قوم ظلموا أنفسهم فأهلكته وما ظلمهم الله ولكن أنفسهم يظلمون.
مثل ما ينفقون في هذه الحياة الدنيا. The similitude or the example of or the comparison of the wealth that the kuffar, the disbelievers, are spending in this world in order to prevent people from entering in the deen of Allah. Some ulama said, أراد نفقات أبي سفيان وأصحابه ببدر وأهد على عداوة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Some ulama said, it is a reference to the money that Abi Sufyan and his friends spent in the battle of Badr and battle of Uhud against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making a reference that all the money they spend, they will not get any benefit out from it. It will become a regret to them. And he said, مَثَلُ مَا يُنْفِقُونَ, the similitude or the comparison of the wealth that the disbelievers are spending fi hadhihi al-hayat, in this world. That's why I say, fi hayati dunya, in this lively world. And their sadaqah. Some ulama too say, according to Muqatil, he said, it's nafakatul al-yahud ala ulama'ihim. It's the expenditure, the money that the Jews, they spend for their rabbis, so that they don't have to tell the people the truth concerning the attribute of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in their books. Some too say, no. Yani, it's a reference to al-mura'i. Somebody who spend money fisabilillah, but in the case of riyah, he do it for people to see. It also enter. So here, this ayah, we can say it's a general for anybody who spend in a sin. You spend money in lottery. You spend money in alcohol. You spend money to block people from entering in the deen. You spend money for some people in order not to tell the people the truth. Or you spend some money not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you enter in this explanation. And Allah said, كَمَثَلِ is the similitude, or it's like a wind. فيها سر. The word سر, the ulama of tafsir, they have different meaning. Okay? Hukiya an Ibn Abbas, according to Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, the word سر means أنها السموم الحارة التي تقتل. It is a very hot wind. Samum is hot. A wind that is coming, but it is very hot. And whenever it touches you, it destroys you. This is the explanation given to Abdullah ibn Abbas concerning sur. And some ulama say sur means assault. It's a wind that have a very terrible sound. Whenever it's blowing, you hear a sound in it. This is another explanation. Wa akthar al-mufassirin. But according to the majority of the ulama of tafsir, they said the meaning of sur is baradun shadid. It's a very severe cold. It's a wind that have a very severe cold. Whenever it touches you, it paralyzes you or it destroys you. Okay? So the word sur, it have different meanings. Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said it's a very hot. According to some people, they say it's a sound. And according to the majority of ulama of tafsir, they say the meaning of sur is cold. That is a very severe cold. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the expenditure of the disbelievers in preventing people to enter in the deen is just like a wind with a terrible cold. Okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Aswabat haritha qawmin. And this wind touches the crop of people. People has planted something and the thing has germinated, has grown very nice. And this terrible wind come and blow it, and then it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, ahalakatuko. Fa'alakatu, then it destroy it. Okay? They have suffered for nothing. They have weed planted, they have toiled, made a lot of effort to keep their crop germinating. And alhamdulillah, the crop has germinated and grow very nice with its fruit. Then at the last hour, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought this wind to smash it and then destroy it. You can see that their toil, their effort, their work had all gone in vain. Had all been in vain because they didn't get any benefit from it. And this is the similitude of those who are spending money in order to block the thing. They will work, but they will never get any benefit out of it. That's why Allah said, "Kamasal rih." It's just like a wind. The wind, you can take it to be a cold wind, but it better will go according to the explanation of the majority of the ulama of tafsir. Majority of them, they agree that the sur is a very cold wind. That it touches haritha qawmin, the crop of some people. Which people? Zalamu anfusahum. People who has wronged themselves. People who have wronged themselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fa'ahalakathu. Then it destroyed the crops. Faman al-ayah. مثل نفقات الكفار في ذهابها وقت الحاجة إليها كمثل الزرع. It's an example of the expenditure, the money that the disbelievers they spend in order to block the people from entering the deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this example like somebody who suffered and made a farm. After everything had grown, some wind came and blew it. He didn't get even one crop, one single fruit to eat. He suffered for nothing. The same thing the kuffar. They will spend their money. They will do anything in order to block the deen, to prevent Islam from spreading. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَعْبَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا أَنْ يُتِمَّ نُورًا. Okay? Because don't forget, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يُرِدُونَ أَنْ يُتْفِهُكُمْ نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ. He used يُرِدُونَ, which is fil mudari, which is present continuous. Up to today, they are doing it. لِيُتْفِهُ نُورَ اللَّهِ. They want to quench the light of Allah, which is Islam. Okay? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُزْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ. Even though the disbelievers, they don't like it. Because the disbelievers know that they don't like the spread of Islam and then they relax. No, they are working to prevent the spread of Islam. And here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them they will spend their money, they will waste their energy, and all will become in vain. They will never get anything out of it now.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا بطانة من دونكم لا يألونكم خبالا ودوا ما عنتم قد بلت البغضاء من أفواههم وما تخفي صدورهم أكبر قد بينا لكم الآيات إن كنتم تعقلون.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا أو you who believe لا تتخذوا بطانة. Don't take protectors or advisors, okay? Min dunikum, from people who are outside your religion. Don't take people as your special advisors who are not Muslims. Don't seek for protection from people who are not Muslims. Don't seek for help from people who are not Muslims, okay? Because the word mitana is homonymous. Is homonymous. Is it correct say?
Homonym.
Homonym, no? Synonym is one word. Homonym. I think it's homonym is one word with a lot of meaning. So the word betana, it has a lot of meaning. You can see here that according to Abdullah ibn Abbas, كان رجال من المسلمين يواصلون اليهود لما بينهم من القرابة والصداقة والحلف والجواء والرضاع فأنزل الله سبحانه وتعالى هذه الآية ينهاهم عن مباطنتهم خوف الفتنة عليهم. According to Abdullah ibn Abbas, some of the Muslims were having secret relationship or very serious relationship with some disbelievers. Some of them, the reason that they have some family relationship, they are their kinship. Some of them, they are their friends. Some of that, they are allies, because some of them were having allies, you know. Some of them, they were having a relationship of matrimony, like I married his sister or she married. They have some relationship. Because of that, they were sharing some secret, serious advices with them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited them from making such secret with non-Muslims. Because if you do it, he can reveal it to Muslims. Okay? وَقَالَ مُجَاهِدْ. According to Mujahid, he and his sheikh, because he's a student of Ibn Abbas, cool? But what happened? He has different opinion. According to him, he said, نَزَلَتْ فِي قَوْمِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This ayah came talking about some people among the believers. كَانُوا يُسَافُونَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ. They were making good friendship with hypocrites. Okay? And Allah said, no. فَنَهَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited them from doing that. فَقَالْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَا do who believe? I need to speak outside. لَا تَتَّخِذُوا بِطَانَةً. Don't hold awliya, helpers, or asfiya, like six lost friends. مِنْ دُونِكُمْ means مِنْ غَيْرِ أَهْلِ مِلَّتِكُمْ. Mm-hmm. To take friends from people who are not in your religion. Okay? وَبِطَانَةَ الرَّجُلْ خَصَفُ. Bitanata is like cabinet today. In the modern Arabic, the meaning has changed. The cabinet, political cabinet, they call it Bitana. Who sit down and decide something for the nation. So your Bitana is somebody that you share your serious secret with. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that a Muslim, you don't have to have the person you share your serious secret to be non-Muslim. Okay? That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. Summa bayyana illata fi an-nahy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disclose, explain the reason why he prohibits us from taking those people as our serious friends. He said, "La ya'lunakum khabara." They will not stop to corrupt you. They will not stop. La ya'lu. They will not stop. La yuksirun. They will not make weak. La yatrukun. They will not stop juhudahum. Their effort. Fi ma yurithukum ash-shar. In doing what will bring corruption, wal fasad, and mischief on you people. Okay? No matter how kafir is kafir, he will never love you a Muslim. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling. And according to grammatically, you can see that the Quran said, La ya'lunakum. Then he said, khabalan. The khabalan, they give it fataha. Okay? When you see khabalan al-maf'ul thani, it has been given fataha because it is transitive verb. Okay? We have transitive verb. And you have intransitive verb, fi'l lazim and fi'l muta'addi. And in Arabic, the fi'l muta'addi, we have some fi'l, we have some verbs, they transit to one object, because we have verb, the subject, and the object. And some of the fi'l, they transit to double object. In English, we call it direct object and indirect object, I think. But in Arabic, we have maf'ul al-awwal wa maf'ul al-thani. We have some verbs in Arabic. Whenever they see them, they need two objects. Like if I say hasibtu, zaydan, aqilan. Like hasibtu, khiltu. Okay, zanantu. In grammatical, we call them zanantu wa akhwatiha. That is zanantu and its brothers. They always need maf'ulain. They need double object. And this verb, la ya'alu. This verb, ya'alu, is one of those verbs that need double object. That is why you can see that the Quran said, La ya'alunakum. So the kum is the first object. It's maf'ul. Because ya, la ya'aluna is fil mudari. Marfu. Okay? Wa alamati raf'ihi. Subutun nun. Li'annahu min af'al al-khamsa. Ko? Wa wawul jama'a. Fa'il. Ko? Why maf'ul? Kum, which is domir al-muttasil. This domir al-muttasil represents the first object. Maf'ul al-awwal. Then khabalan become the maf'ul al-thani. So this is the Iran. So you can see that they will not stop their effort in order to corrupt you, to get you Muslims deviated from your religion. This is an opinion of some of the ulama of grammar. Okay? And waqila, some ulama say no. This khabalan, they give it fatha, binaz'il khafid. There is huruf al-jar. In Arabic, we have some huruf al-khafid. Huruf al-jar, they are some articles that whenever they enter in a noun, they give the end kasra. Like min, wa ila, wa an, wa ala, wa fi, wa rubba, wa ba, wa kef. All this one, they are huruf al-jar. Whenever they, fi sabili, la, you cannot say fi sabilu. I will say no, this is not Arabic. Because whenever you see fi, the now that will meet, the end should be kasra. So here, the meaning is la ya'lunakum bil khabali. Had it been the ba was there, the khabali will get kasra. So they remove the ba. Since they remove the ba, then they have to give it fataha. And in the Arabic language, the Arabs, they use this thing. Okay? For example, the Arabs used to say, awja'atuhu darban. Okay? I hate him. Beating. I hate him. Beating. The normal Arabic language is supposed to be awja'atuhu bidarbi. I hurt him with beating. But they remove the bar and then they let the darban represent fataha. Here we can say it is far, it is hard. Okay? So may Allah give us understanding. Mm. Anyhow, you take it, it's correct, it will not change the meaning. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, La ya'alunakum qabalan. They will not stop making their effort. Okay? To what? To corrupt you. Okay? To see a Muslim, he will be telling you, I'm a Muslim liberal. I'm a modern Muslim. That's what they want. Well, you can be drinking alcohol, no problem. You can be going to disco, no problem. Or you can be moving with girls, no problem. Modern is modern Muslim. Okay? This is what they want to call La ya'lunakum khabalan. They will not stop doing something that will corrupt you, that will get you deviated from your religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continued. And he said, "Waddu ma anittum." Okay, keep up.
Yeah.
"Waddu ma anittum." And they always need what will give you, what will suffer you, what will hurt you. The khabalan is the one to corrupt your religion. And what do they wish ma anittum? What will hurt you physically? You can see that the hurt is double. Okay? Psychologically, to corrupt your thinking in religion, and physically, to weak you. Okay, this is what they are looking for. That's why I said, يَوَدُّونَ مَا يَشُقُّ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنَ الدُّرْ وَالشَّرْ وَالْحَلَاقِ. They need whatever will hurt you, be it a sickness, be it a catastrophe, or be it anything that will give you weakness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَدْ بَدَتِ الْبَغْضَاءُ مِنْ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ. Allahu Akbar. Because the hatred had been plain from their mouth. Hatred for you Muslims is very clear from their mouth. Subhanallah. Bishatima, by insulting you, wal waqi'a, and then also trying to defame your personalities fil muslimin. Waqila bittila'il mushrikeen ala asrarul mu'minin. Those who take the verse to be talking about the hypocrite, they say the meaning is the hypocrites, whenever they come to the Muslims, they hear what the Muslims are doing, they go to the disbelievers, they tell them. Okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continued and said, وَمَا تُخْفِي صُدُورُهُمْ. But what their breast is hiding مِنَ الْعَدَاوَى, from hatred, والغيظ, and anger, or rage, Allah said, أكبر, is bigger than what they have said with their mouth. The hatred they have for you Muslims in their heart is severe, is very bigger than what you people hear from their mouth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَدْ بَيَّنَّا لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ. We have made all these verses, all these things very clear for you people. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. So that you reason, you use your mind. May Allah give us understanding.
Now. إن الله عليم بذات الصدور.
Ha, antum. In Arabic, the ha is tanbih. Like ذلِكَ or هذا. هذا is a demonstrative pronoun in Arabic. But the real pronoun is ذا. Va is the pronoun, but the ha is tanbih, is to attract your like, hey, this. So ha is tanbih, is to attract your attention. Okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why you can see, he said that ha is tanbih. Wa antum, because it said ha antum. So the ha is hey, like so, making something to attract your attention so that you will bring your mind to what we want to tell you. Then he said, antum wa antum kinayatun lil mukhatabin min al-dhukur. It is an expression that we use for the second person pronoun. We know in English we have first person and second person and the third person. The first person is the speaker, in which in Arabic we call it al-mutakallim. Okay? And the second person is the mukhatab. In English we say the second person. And the ghaib is the third person. So antum is the second person plural. Plural, because in Arabic anta, first person masculine singular. Second person masculine singular. Then if I say anti, it's the same thing, second person feminine singular. But if I say antum, then this is a second person plural masculine. Because if it is feminine, it will be antum. Okay? So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use ha antum. Then he bring another ismul ishara. Ula'i, ismul ishara. Ismul ishara means demonstrative pronoun. Okay? Ilayhim, yani yuridu antum ayyuhal mu'minin. Oh, you believers. Tuhibbunahum. Ay, tuhibbunaha ula'i al-yahud. You love these Jews and Christians. You Muslims love them. You can see what happened in Khaybar when the Prophet went there. He left them. They were with them. When we went to Medina, we were marrying them. We were living with them very peacefully. There was no problem. Only the Muslims had problem with them when they formed alliance with disbelievers to fight against Muslims. Don't forget, the concept of jihad came in deen. The Prophet was in Mecca 3 for good 13 years. He never takes sword to fight anybody. They were beating the Muslims, killing them, maltreating them to try to let them to disown their, to reject their religion. But that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't give the Prophet chance to fight. Till it reached that the Muslims has to abandon Medina, Mecca, and migrate to Medina. Some of them left their wealth. Even I remember one Sahaba, he wanted to do hijrah, and they attacked him. And he said, hey, I have a huge amount of money in Mecca. Let me show you where my wealth is. Go and take it and leave me alone. Let me go with my deen. And he showed them where his wealth was. They went and took it, and they left him. Subhanallah. They prefer to hold their religion, to lose their wealth. Because they know that the world will not take them to anywhere. These are the qualities of the Sahaba. Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that we the Jews, we the Muslims, we like the Jews. You love them. These people that I told you that you don't have to trust them now, before you people love them. Allah is making reference. Okay? And he said, wa hum yuhibbunakum. They don't love you. You people love them. They don't love. Why they don't love them? Here he said, "Lima baynakum min mukhalafati ad-din." The reason is that you people are not on the same deen, so they will never like you. Somebody who is not in your deen will never like you. He will like you because of some benefit of the world. He will like you.
Compromise.
But in reality, I don't think. Kala mukatil. According to mukatil, humu munafikun. Yuhibbuna al-mu'minun. Yuhibbunahum mu'minun. Or Yuhibbuhumul mu'minun. According to Muqatil, he said, this is also a reference. Don't forget, since the beginning, we said that some of the ulama take it to be kuffar, some of them take it to be hypocrite. So Muqatil said here, he said, the hypocrite, the Muslims, they love them. Why? Lima azharu min al-iman. Because since they came and said, La ilaha illallah, the Muslims know that they are their brothers. They are just like them. So they love them. Wala ya'lamuna ma fi qulubihim. And they don't know what is in their heart. Subhanallah. And Allah continues, but this verse is talking about the Jews. Okay, ha antum, haula. Here you are, believers. Tuhibbunahum, you love them, wala yuhibbunakum, they don't love you. Wa tu'minuna bil kitabi kulli. Look, Arabic. Al kitab is a singular, it's a mufrad. You believe in book, but here, by saying kulli, it means not only one book, it is a singular that represents a plural. A singular representing plural, meaning all the scriptures, all the book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, sent down in this world, you Muslims, you believe in all, including At-Tawrah and Injil. That's why he said, وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْكِتَابِ كُلِّ. يعني بالكتب كلها. وهم لا يؤمنون بكتابكم. But they don't believe with this Quran that people are reading. We can see some of them used to despise it. Subhanallah. وَإِذَا لَقُوكُمْ When they meet you, قَالُوا they said, آمَنَّا we believe. وَإِذَا خَلَوْا But if they turn back, if they go, وَكَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ مَعْ بَعْضٍ and meet their brothers in Aqeedah, عَدُّوا عَلَيْكُمُ الْأَنَامِلِ They bite the tip of their fingers at you من الغيظ out of rage because of hunger. Anger, not hunger. Annoyance is anger, no? Or rage. You can see this verse. You can explain it with the disbelievers. You can also explain it with the hypocrites. You can see that we read back that the disbelievers, they said, believe in Muhammad. Believe in what Muhammad is reading in the daytime, but in the night, disbelieve. Okay? And don't forget, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was describing the hypocrite, and he said, وَإِذَا لَكُلْ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَهْزِئُونَ So one verse, it hit all of them. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when they meet you people, they say, we believe. But whenever they go back and meet their shayateen, their people who by they are the same in the Aqeedah, That's why he said no. Abdu alaykum al-anamil. They bite the tip of their finger, okay, at you, min al-ghayz, out of rage. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet, Kul tell them, mutu bi-ghayzikum. You should die. You should perish with your rage, with your anger. You will be annoyed till bursting. You can never hurt the believers. That's why I say, mutu bi-ghayzikum. Perish with your rage. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ Allah is aware. He knows all the things that is hidden in the chest. All the bad intentions we're having with the believers, all Allah knows is. So your plot will come to vain. Now.
إِن تَمْسَسْكُمْ حَسَنَةٌ تَسُؤُهُمْ وَإِن تُصِبْكُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ يَفْرَحُوا بِهَا وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْئًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ
إِن تَمْسَسْكُمْ حَسَنَةٌ One good thing before on you. Okay? When you have a good thing. أيها المؤمنون تُصِبْكُمْ أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ بِزُهُورِكُمْ عَلَى عَدُوِّكُمْ That is If you believers have victory over your enemies, وغنيمة, or you have booty, وتتابعوا الناس, or they see that a lot of people are entering in the deen, يعني في الدخول في دينكم, وخسب في معيشتكم, or they see that even your crops, in the Muslim world, the crops has grown very good and the food are bounty, تسوهم. It grieves them. It grieves them. Is it good English?
Yes.
It makes them unhappy. Whenever they see you progressing, let us put it in the shortest way. Whenever they see you Muslims progressing, it grieves them, it pains them. وَإِن تُصِبُكُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ But when evil befall on you against you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say me, تَصُرُّهُمْ كُو يَفْرَهُ They make happy, they rejoice. When the life, this life, is to laugh today and cry tomorrow. To get today and tomorrow don't get. To born, to die. To make wedding, to divorce. Whether you didn't divorce, one day you die and live here. It's just like divorce. Okay? That is life. And this is general. Be you a Muslim or a non-Muslim. Everybody will go through this because this is the natural phenomenon of creation. Allah made it like that. And Allah is telling us here that whenever these disbelievers, they see any progress with you Muslims, it grieves them. And they, when they see a problem, let me say, what is the opposite of progress? Downfall, or calamity, or problem, then they rejoice for that. Okay? And Allah subhanahu gave us the formula by which, if we follow, they can never prevail upon us. He said, wa in tasbiru, if you make patience, ala adahim, adahum, to the hurt and the problems that these believers are making on to you believers, if you have patience, not only patience, what a taqwa, and you have taqwa, you fear Allah, you stick to doing what Allah had commanded you people to do, and stay away from what Allah has prohibited you people to do. What Allah said, la yadurrukum, their plot, their cunning, okay, their cunning or their plot can never ever hurt you, wouldn't even with a small thing. I ma'anaha, according to, let's come back, according to Ibn Kathir and Nafi and the people of Busra, they read this place different way. It's two kira. Some people read it, la yadurrukum, that this place, they read it with kasra, yani, the kasra is sword. They say, la yadurrukum, khafifa, without, that is the ra, will not have shadda. Okay, they read it, la yadurrukum. Okay, kaydu, la yadurrukum shay'a. That's why they read the people of Nafi and Ibn Kathir and the people of Busra. Okay, and they give it jazm. That time they don't give the ra dhamma. They do it la yadurrukum. Why? Because if you remember, it's fi'l al-shart. Say in tasbiru. So it is fi'l al-shart. So it needs jaza. Jaza al-shart. This is grammatical, you know. So the jaza al-shart is la yadurrukum. Okay. And according to some of the kira'a, they read it la yadurrukum, as here in Hafs, la yadurrukum is the same thing. The la yadurrukum is la yadurrukum. Don't forget, whenever you see anywhere with shadda, it means that word is two. So the school is still there. La yadurrukum. And the la yadurrukum, they rob the first ra, which is having the dhamma, because la yadurruk, the first ra has dhamma, they rob the first ra, and they put that dhamma on the dot, because it's la yadurrukum. The dot has got school. So they remove the dhamma from the first ra, they put it on the dot. And this ra, that they rob it, they replace it with shadda on the second one. This is in qira'a tajweed, okay? This is tajweed. And then also, there is another explanation grammatically. If you could remember, day before yesterday, I made mention that if a verb is conditional, like harful shart, like in, when it comes, it needs two verbs. The first verb is fi'l shart, and the second verb is jawab shart. When the jawab comes, something comes to be the jawab, to be the answer, the reply to the condition, whereby it's not a verb, then they have to put fa. If you remember, I said this day before yesterday or 3 days ago. The same thing, so ulama explained here. They said the meaning was funny, and the meaning is wa in tasbiru wa tattaqu fa laysa yadurrukum shay'a. Fa is there, and laysa, they remove it. So they say that la means laysa. Eh? Because it said wa in tattaqu wa in tasbiru wa tattaqu la yadurrukum. So this la is laysa. It's laysa, meaning فَلَيْسَ يَدُرُّكُمْ كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْعَ. Their plot and cunning can never hurt you with anything. Because إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had encompassed, had surrounded, which means He is controlling all what they are doing. So they cannot hurt you, all believers, as far as you are patient and you stick to my rules and regulations. Now,
وإذ غدوت من أهلك تبوئ المؤمنين مقاعد للقتال والله سميع عليم.
وإذ غدوت من أهلك, remember, O Rasulullah, O Muhammad, when you went out from your household in the morning, تبوئ المؤمنين, where you were positioning the believers, you were putting them in a position, okay, مقاعد للقتال, in a post of a battle, they were going to battle. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were putting everybody in his post. You remain here. You stand here. You stay here. And the ulama of tafsir, Qala al-Hasan, he said, Yawm Badr, this ayah is a reference to Badr. Wa qala Muqatil, Yawm al-Ahzab. Muqatil said, no, it's a reference to the battle of Ahzab. Wa qala Sa'id al-Mufassirin, and all the majority of the ulama of tafsir, always we are with the majority, okay? If the majority have right, okay? وَهُوَ يَوْمُ الْأُهُدِ. This is a reference of the day of Uhud. There are so many reasons by which we can stand on it and say this ayah was talking or is talking about Uhud. There are a lot of reasons. لِأَنَّ مَا بَعْدَهُ قَرِيبٌ. من آخر سورة الحرب أهد. قال مجاهد والكلبي والواقدي غدا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من منزل عائشة رضي الله عنها فمشى على رجليه إلى أهد. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went out in the morning from the house of his wife Aisha, walking on his legs till he reached Uhud. فجعل يصف أصحاب للقتال. And he started arranging the Sahaba for battle. And what happened? You can see the Prophet was with Aisha and he left the house in the morning. Okay? He went to Uhud to position his, to arrange his people. إِنَّ الْمُشْرِكُونَ according to Muhammad ibn Isaac and Suddi, they said, إِنَّ الْمُشْرِكِينَ نَزَلُوا بِأُهُدِ يَوْمَ الْأَرْبِعَاءِ